Nine lawmakers in the Ondo State House of Assembly have asked the Ondo Chief Judge, Olarenwaju Akeredolu, to uphold Section 188 of the Nigerian Constitution in an ongoing move to impeach Deputy Governor Agboola Ajayi. The nine lawmakers are those against the impeachment move against the Deputy Governor on the grounds that due process was not followed. In an open letter, the lawmakers said they were notifying the Chief Judge based on plans by the leadership of the House to suspend some of them in order to carry out the impeachment. They are said they are not in support of the impeachment based on their individual personal conviction. Joining us to give an insight into the political differences is Omoshola Deji, a political scientist currently in Singapore, but obviously following the developments in Ondo State. Good morning, Omoshola.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
It's our pleasure. What's your reaction to the impeachment plot against the deputy governor of that state?
Well, the impeachment plot against the Deputy Governor of Ondo State is the executive headed by the governor not being able to separate politics from governance. Now, there are two sides to it on the part of the embattled Deputy Governor. The morality side, that, okay, he has left the APC and now he has to leave office. Now, there's also the part of justice that, okay, but the law doesn't mandate him to leave office. So it is left for him to uphold the part of morality or stick to justice. But at this point in time, the embattled deputy governor said, oh, he would rather stick on the part of justice than morality. And the Supreme Court, in the case of Atiku and OBJ, Obasanjo, had settled case that if you leave the party, it doesn't mean that you are automatically leaving office. Because then Atiku left to the ACN and they settled the matter in court. So right now, it is between morality and justice, governor and his the governor and his deputy. But then again, at this point in time, what Ondo State should be focused on is really the issue of the pandemic, how to deliver palliatives to people, not about playing politics around the clock. And this thing may, at the end of the day, make the embattled deputy governor more popular, because outside the confines of the state, not many people can resonate with the name Agboola. But now, as it is going, so many people are beginning to know the name, are beginning to get familiar with the personality of the man. And if this thing is not done carefully, definitely the man might win the sympathy of the people. And I believe that since the justice aspect of it favors the embattled deputy governor, then the governor himself, as senior advocate of Nigeria, having known his heart of heart that it is not necessary for the deputy governor to vacate office, I would have expected that he would have focused on governance. And the threat by the people in his party to boycott the primary election, having adopted indirect primary by the party. So he should have focused on winning the primary election so that at the end of the day, perhaps he can win the MP.
All right, let me interject. The network is acting up a bit. Can you hear me?
Loud and clear, please.
All right, Omoshola. Do you think that the state chief justice can intervene or interpret this case as requested by the anti-impeachment lawmakers, or that will be a breach of the separation of power?
Well, it's a breach on the separation of power. Justice only comes in when the process of impeachment has been transmitted to him, and he would set up a 7-man panel of impeccable character to handle the case. So right now, if anybody is to interface with the Chief Justice, it is the face of the legislature, who in this case is the Speaker, that has the right to interface with the Chief Justice. And it can only do that after one third of the House of Assembly has signed the impeachment proceeding, and the Chief Justice is to constitute a panel who will now determine whether the Deputy Governor is guilty of the allegation as charged. But what the Constitution says about infractions is that the Deputy Governor must have committed a gross misconduct, which is a violation of the Constitution.
All right.